If somebody asks you to name all the body parts that's important to punch with a lot of power, which body part would you say? Hips, knee, the fist itself? Well, have you thought about the stomach? Today's topic is going to be how we utilize our stomach to punch powerful. So stay tuned. Hi guys, I'm Yusuke Nagano from Karate Dojo Waku. And if it's your first time checking out my channel, this channel is on kata and kumite tutorials. So today, we're going to learn how to punch with a lot of power by using our stomach. So maybe are you guys familiar with this phrase of tanden? Tanden is the part that concentrates all the weight of your body. Meaning, if you have a very low stance, that means your tanden is very deep in, meaning it's very low. If the stance is high, the tanden becomes high. So the position of the center of your weight is commonly referred to as tanden. Some people say that there are three tandens, the upper one, the middle one, and the lower one. And they say that by controlling the position of these 10 tandens, it becomes easier for you to execute your techniques. But what does that even mean? What does it mean to control your tanden? Well, if I were to explain it in a simpler way, it means to stretch out your abs like you do in archery. In archery, you pull the bow and you release, right? By bending the bow, the force of it going back to its straight form produces power. In baseball, when they pitch a ball, they would stretch and then contract, right? Anything else? In soccer, they don't kick like this. They stretch out and then they kick. So every kind of sport has this extending and contracting. In karate, we have that as well. Let's take an example of an oizuki. In oizuki, a very common way is to not use these parts. And you think of these as a brick. And you just move your hand. Of course, you push out with your lower body, but this part is like a brick. However, what you want to do, you don't want to over-exaggerate this. It might be hard to see, but first, you start by crushing your abs together. So rather than doing this, ab is crushed. From here, when you start moving forward, you kind of relax your abs. So this is crushed now. Now it's relaxed. And then you crush it again. So it goes from, so I'll put my hand here. First it's crushed. Like this. But please don't, when you try to imagine this, don't pull your shoulder back. Like, don't do this. Then if you change the outer structure of your body, the opponent will notice something's coming. So what you want to do is change the inside, meaning changing how you move the muscle of the inner muscles. So from here, crush, release, crush, release. I'm still able to use the contraction of my body to produce power. So, I mean, it was a quick video today, but if this concept was new for you, then please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. This concept of expanding and contracting can be used a lot in karate, especially in an oizuki. So please do that. And if you like to apply oizuki in katas, I recommend you check out a Heian Shodan video, which I did before, because I complied all the detailed basics of an oizuki there. Also, check out these two videos. And I hope to see you guys in the next one.